Today we are looking at a 3.2 liter four cylinder that will hopefully make close to 3000 horsepower, as close as we can get. And of course we are starting this build by selecting our displacement and of course setting all the other parameters up, like our cam setup, and of course we are selecting our materials. One of those said materials is of course aluminum, bullet aluminum to be specific. For this rotating assembly we are going to use for now a forged rotating assembly with bullet parts in some areas like the crankshaft, and the rest is forged. We are using quality status that is on plus 15, VDT on all cams, single turbo configuration because that's what's available to us. Fuel system, we are using a direct injector per cylinder configuration race intake manifold on my favorite fuel, which is nitro methane, and we're using the same quality status as the rest of the engine build so far. Now we're using a tubular race header, no cat, no muffler, none of that. Come on game, don't be like that, thank you. We are cruising along with 1309 horsepower, that is already crazy, but I see we're running into an RPM problem. We might have to go back and change our conrod, because I see that is the main problem. Although, if you take the displacement of this engine, this thing is ginormous, and our flowchart is telling us we have a whole slew of issues, including the exhaust, intercooler and compressor. We're gonna go and address the compressor issue first, because that's the one that is the one with the most problems. Excuse me, getting used to the evil here. But anyway. Almost 2000 horsepower, 1988 to be specific. We're gonna try a few tricks to get us up to our number, and our conrod is still being a problem, so we're gonna have to go back and change it. Now we're switching to a titanium conrod. Yes, it can't hold as much torque, but it can rev a little more. We're gonna push it up to 9500. I think that's a safe place to leave it. Let's go back and add some more boost. Let's make those rotating assembly parts really work their butts off. 2600 already, that is good. 2700 is already looking good before it decided to break. So I'm going to lower the RPM a slight bit, see if that helps. If we move more boost, we can't. It's still amazing that 1.8 bar boost on nitro methane with the configuration we have can produce as much horsepower as it does. We're going to try a different trick, we're going to add a little more spring with tension, then we're going to add our RPM back and see if that helps. I don't think it's going to, but so far so good I guess. So that doesn't help. If we go up, it breaks. So let's see, can we mess with fuel? No, we cannot. So let's go mess with the exhaust, because it has 108% flow rate, so that's bad. Very, very bad. Does not need to be that restricted. That's better, 69%. nice. That's my reenactment of that, and I know it is absolutely atrocious, and I apologize. And if you like this kind of content, do consider to hit that subscribe button, smash that like button, and let me know what's your favorite engine configuration, or your favorite mean for that sake. So, now we've got all the YouTube stuff out of the way, we can continue our engine build. Thank you for listening. 2,838 horsepower is crazy, and we are just pushing along. I think we can get up to 2.9. Is that possible? Yes, it is. Our reliability is tanking again, but it's starting to go up slightly. Don't know how that logic works, but okay. 2,988 horsepower. I know we can get to 3000, come on, we have to at least get there easily. Come on, a little more. We have to do something, so I think. If we just keep on pushing, yes, the reliability is going to tank, and there we have it, my number is beautiful. So now we're going to do two engine pulls, one looking at this beautiful engine, one looking at the graph, so let's go. Yeah, no, that engine sounds incredible. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you wonderful people next one. Bye-bye.